Okay, everybody, welcome back to Learn with Minecraft Education. We are today going to be taking a quick look at command blocks. So, command blocks are very useful. We have looked briefly at putting in commands in the chat box and the kind of things that those can do. There are limitations, and that's where command blocks come in. Now, first things first, we need to give ourselves a command block. So let's go ahead and go into the chat box. You cannot go into your inventory and search for, even in creative mode, search for command blocks. You need to give them to yourself in the chat and command window. So press T or enter to open that up. And we're going to do /give. And we're going to give at S. I'm going to give yourself com. We're going to type the first three letters of command block, and then it's auto completed there at the top, so we're going to hit tab to go down and complete that for us. So as we press tab, it will start going through that list there on the left, so we keep pressing it until we get what we want, and then we hit enter, and as you can see in our inventory now, we have a command block. I'm going to get a couple of other bits and bobs for this tutorial, so let's get a board as well so that we can put some instructions on there. Let's get a lever and let's get a button also. A button. Two T's, obviously. Come on. Now, we are going to place down our command block, like so. Now, let's place another one here and take a careful look. As you can see, we've got some different shapes on the side. The top and bottom there, we've got a square and a circle, and around the edges, we've got some arrows, and those arrows will come in handy later on. So let's put a board behind it and just type day. And let's put a lever on this. If we want to put a lever on a command block, we have to hold shift, place the lever on like so, and shift will also crouch us down. Let's do the same over here, similar setup. Let's change this one to night and put a lever on this one too. So obviously what we want to do is we want a lever that changes the world time. It sets the world time to day, and another lever that sets it to night. So let's go to our command block, command input, and let's do time set day. And you will notice you do not need a forward slash in a command block. It's not necessary. It will still work, but it's not necessary. Let's go ahead and do the same thing on this one, but we'll do time set night. That one. You can just click here and type directly in as well, you don't have to click the plus. And let's see how we're doing. So this one should be night. Good. So we've flicked the switch there and it's turned from day to night. There we go. Let's have a look. This one. That's working nicely, very good. So basically the command block there, very simply, executing a command with a redstone signal. Okay, so clearly the redstone signal there interacting with the command block and it's executing that command. There are lots of other things you can do with these. There are lots of ways to supply a redstone signal. You can use a redstone block or a torch or a button or a lever or a pressure plate or something like that. But let's go ahead and look at a different function of command blocks. Let's put one like this. I'll put one in front of it because you can have multiple commands. So let's change this one to a repeat block. And we'll leave all this stuff the same. We won't put any code in there. So when this when this block receives a redstone signal, it will pass on the information to this one, and as long as it's receiving the redstone signal, it will keep repeating that, which is the important part about the repeater. And let's have our command here that we want to repeat. And let's do a command that's kind of hard, to repeat without using a repeater block. So let's use summon. Summon pig. So normally we'd have to summon, you know, one pig at a time. But if we press this button, here's the other thing. We do need to change this stuff ever so slightly. So this needs to be chain, because we've chained it to another command block. And this needs to say always active, so it doesn't need to receive a redstone signal to be activated. It just receives the signal from the repeat command block, the repeating command block. It doesn't need a separate redstone signal to power it as well, which is what we want. So let's press the button, and we get a whole load of pigs popping out. Obviously, if that button was a lever, the pigs would keep coming until we switch the lever off. And in a previous video I was trying, I did use a lever. I couldn't get to the lever because there were so many pigs flying out of the box there on the top. So the button works well. Let's do that again, just demonstrate that. All those pigs. Obviously the pig is going to get a bit annoying, so we'll /kill at E, that's all entities. There you go. Now, let's have a play around. Let's put another command block on the end there. Let's make it a chain. Let's make it always active. And just to demonstrate how we can link up and chain these command blocks, let's put in something that we want to happen after all the pigs are flying, coming out of the box. So let's do effect. Let's do all entities. Let's do E. Yeah, effect at E. And we'll do levitation. So what should happen here is the pigs should pop out. Just check the settings here. Always active. Good. The pigs should pop out here, and then they should all be affected by levitation. Let's see if that works. There are the pigs, and off they go, flying up. So the first command block is the repeater that sent the signal to create all of the pigs. The second block created them, and the third block on the end there applied a line of a command to all entities to levitate, and that is applying to all the other entities here. There's a chicken over there as well. So it's not just the pigs. And then after 30 seconds, that wears off, and the pigs come crashing down. So yeah, we've got the three different types of command blocks there. The arrows are important. These arrows, when you're chaining them like this, they need to be pointing in the same direction. So you could, for example, then go like this, if you see what I mean. So you can turn corners with these. But if you want lots and lots of commands all taking place one time after the other, chaining them up like that is the way to do it. Other simple commands that you can do very quickly. Of course, if you want to do something like teleport, let's do TP at P, which will be the nearest player. And we will teleport them to, let's keep the X axis where it is. Let's go on the Y axis, let's go up by 40. And on the Z axis, let's leave that where it is. So it should shoot us up 40 blocks into the air. And we'll have a lever to activate that. There we go. So flick the lever, and it shoots you up 40 blocks into the air. So if there are any commands you can think of in the chat and commands box here, so if I go /, it starts to auto-complete these. I can use tab to go through them. any commands that you can find in here will also work as a command block as well. So there's thousands and thousands of different ways to use command blocks that might be useful when you're creating a world. Maybe it's for your students or that they're creating for you. Lots of ways to be creative with it. You can summon ender dragons and things like that. If they're not in peaceful mode, they can summon lots of other different things as well, and zombies and so on. And they can create worlds that are designed to be played in survival mode. So you can, for example, get the command block to give at p diamond underscore block, and we'll put a lever on there again, and there we are, hit the lever and it gives us diamond block, and that will work in survival mode. So as long as that is coded in creative mode, and then when you export the world, someone can play it in survival mode, and they can flick a switch to get certain items that they need for certain parts of the level. Okay, so lots and lots of ways to be creative when using command blocks. Super useful tool to learn as an educator using Minecraft education. So I hope this was useful. We might link in some command blocks with redstone builds later on down the line. So do like and subscribe to keep up to date with the videos that I'm posting. And for now, all the best.